None of this stuff has worked out underneath the democratic process. We have been shut out. We have been denied. And only thing an ex-offender has the right to get is his cell back. That's all you got the right in the city is to get your cell back. You ain't got that. Look, these people is upset. They're upset with me. I'm an ex-offender, been to the penitentiary. Not one, three times. I don't know if they more upset than I'm a Republican. I don't know if they more upset than I'm an ex-offender. I don't know if they are more upset than I'm black. I can't tell. But I do know that they are extremely upset with me running for this office and winning the nominee. Then they upset. They want to know why the Republicans, they want the Republicans to come out, denounce him. Denounce him. Condemn him. That's what they want the Republican Party to do. Now don't get it twisted. In the state of Illinois, the state party was, man, don't upset the Republican. The Democrats. Leave the Democrats alone. You might upset the Democrats, and don't do that, Paul. If you're going to run as a Republican, stay centered. Stay in the middle. Keep your hand out toward the other side. Try to work with them. I said, first of all, I ain't no center. I ain't on no fence. If I want to be on their side, I can join them. I'm from the old school. Either you're with me or against me. Man, what side you riding? You got to tell us when you come through, what side? What team you on? You got to tell us, oh, he playing like he on both teams. Both of us get him. After y'all get through, we get him too. That's how it goes. So you can't have it two ways. You either is or you ain't. So the statewide Republicans, they are scared. They don't want to go along and get along. And now let me say something to you about the machine. I want to get back to the machine. The machine is a monster. It is a monster. So when you see Ron Caliglius Emanuel and they tell him that the young child was shot over there, and you see that he's very impartial, he really don't care.
Yeah.
That's how the machine is. They don't care when you tell them, look, y'all closing these schools down, and when you close these schools down, it's going to cause violence, somebody going to get killed. After every school they close, a child get killed. Because they are gangsters. These are gangsters without guns. They just don't carry no gun. Their policy is to make sure that all the money goes to them. So they want you to talk about same-sex marriage. Who cares? You ain't gonna be able to stop nobody from getting married. If two men want to get married, what you gonna do? Run there and handcuff them? Lock them up? They gonna do what they want to do. That's a diversion. That's a bunch of talking about a bunch of no money. They want you over there talking about a bunch of money, no money, while they over here stealing all the money they can steal. And at the same time, they know they're doing some bogus stuff. You know why? Because they want to keep you disarmed. They want to keep you without any weapons so they can keep pulling the stunts that they're doing. They don't want a well-armed society. I said all that to say that a guy can go to the penitentiary three times, can get out the joint, clean his life, change his life, and run for Congress. We've done something in Chicago that the other states, I'm getting word and messages from other states. Guys from other states are saying, how did y'all pull that off? Can y'all come over here and show us? And this brother here from Atlanta, he came up here to support. We got guys come up from other states to support. And most people, they just all disembobulated. That we had the heart and we didn't get permission from the machine to be a man. I don't need nobody permission to be a man. When I did that time, I didn't ask nobody permission to be a man. I had to be a man all by myself. Now I couldn't ask nobody else to be a man for me. And I need us all to stand up as men. I don't need to be in front of y'all. I need to be on the side of y'all. And we need our women to be on the side of us. And let us take the path of victory. You know, let's take this path of victory, because actually we've already won, because our statement is loud and clear. And that statement is this: I'm not no second class citizen. I'm a man. So stop calling me ex-con, ex-this, ex-that. If I wanted to be an ex, it'd be Paul X. That's not my name. My name's Paul McKinley. Call me a man. You call me a man. Now represent our people. Thank you very much.